Hello students, so in the last lecture we have started to understand the optical properties of metal nanoparticles, and we have realized that we have understood a new terminology which is called as an extinction coefficient. Okay, extinction, and we come to know that extinction is a combination of absorption and scattering. So both those things are happening, okay, in case of metal nanoparticles, and because of that the color of the nanoparticle become different, because for the particular wavelength region there is a localized surface plasmon take place, resonance take place, okay, and because of that resonance we realize that that particular metal in that wavelength region shows color, okay, because it absorbs that wavelength in that region. Okay, so in the last lecture we have also seen that it is depends on the plasmon frequency, okay, and we try to understand how the resonance is take place in localized surface plasmon, particularly in case of metal nanoparticle. Okay, so today we are going to see which are the parameters which basically affect this surface plasmon resonance frequency or surface plasmon resonance wavelength. Okay, so these SPR energies, that is the optical properties of metal nanoparticle, depends on six factors. Number one is density of electron, that we have already seen in our last formula of omega p, that the density of electron basically change. So it is a metal dependent. Okay, so it is a metal dependent. So even if you take the gold and silver of identical shape and size, still we are getting different colors. So that is metal dependent. Second is the size of the metal nanoparticles. Okay, so size of the metal nanoparticles. So if you change the size of the metal nanoparticle, again the color of the metal nanoparticle will get changed. The shape of the metal nanoparticles, okay, because previously we just stick to only spherical shape, but if you change the shape from spherical to non-spherical, okay, that is from symmetric to non-symmetric, then definitely there is a change in the color of these nanoparticles. Then composition of metallic alloys. Okay, composition means basically suppose you have silver and gold, and if you make alloy out of it, so you are you started to add silver in gold. Okay, so it is not pure silver or it is not pure gold, but maybe there is a 30-70 proportion ratio or 50-50 proportion ratio, okay, or 60-40 proportion ratio. So likewise you can make alloys of metal nanoparticles. If you make alloy of metal nanoparticle, then again its optical properties are going to change. Then the fifth is the refractive index near the surface of metal nanoparticles. So suppose your metal nanoparticles are present in air, okay, then they will show different color. But same metal nanoparticles when they are present in let us say water, okay, then its color may get change. Okay. And the last is the aggregation of metal nanoparticles. Okay, so suppose we are going to see two cases. If the metal nanoparticles are individual, okay, and if they aggregate, then due to aggregation there is change in the color of the metal nanoparticles. Okay, so all these parameters basically affect on the optical properties of metal nanoparticles. The first we have already seen, that is metal dependent, in our last slide. Now we are going to see what is size, shape, composition, refractive index and aggregation dependent of metal nanoparticles. So as let us start with the size dependent SPR absorption. Okay, so now you can see that the change in size shows the difference in the visible spectrum of gold nanoparticles. Okay, so basically if you take gold nanoparticles and if you change the size of the gold nanoparticles, then you can see that there is a change in the color. that there is a change in the color. So for example, if you take a very small gold nanoparticles, then it show a red color. Okay, but as you are increasing the size of the gold nanoparticle, then it become violet, okay, or it become purple in color, blue in color, okay? Purple in color. So for spherical gold nanoparticles, the color varies from red to purple as the diameter increases. Okay, so as you are increasing the diameter of gold nanoparticles, you have the gold nanoparticles with different colors. So this is the beauty of nano science and nanotechnology, where you have the same gold, okay, atom is same, but just if you shape is also same, right? Because all the nanoparticles are spherical in shape, but just if you change the size of the metal nanoparticle, you realize that its a color is going to change. So this is a why you are getting a different colors, okay, when the size is changed. Okay, so you have multiple colors for gold nanoparticles colloidal solution when we go from bulk to nano. So the size of the nanoparticles influences the relative magnitude of the absorption cross section and cross section of scattering. Okay, why we are getting different colors? Because the absorption cross section and scattering cross section, they both are sensitive to the size of the nanoparticles. Okay, so that we will try to understand, okay, slowly, okay, in this slide. So for nanoparticles smaller than 20 nanometer, the predominant process is absorption. Okay, when the gold nanoparticles are below 20 nanometer, then you can see that absorption is dominant case. Okay, there is a lot of absorption take place, and because the nanoparticles are much smaller in size, they absorb the light. Okay, and it shows beautiful colors. Okay, but an increase in physical dimension or effective size of nanoparticles increases the cross section of scattering. Okay, so suppose if you are if you take this nanoparticle, okay, which is very small, and if you take bigger nanoparticle, okay, as compared to this, so what do you think, scattering is more in which case, smaller or bigger? Okay, yes, you are right. So it will be higher in case of bigger nanoparticle. Okay, so the scattering cross section is higher in this case, and therefore you have to balance the scattering and absorption, right? If scattering is higher, it means absorption is lower. If absorption is higher, it means scattering is lower. So in case of smaller gold nanoparticles, the absorption is higher, scattering is lower, but in case of bigger nanoparticles, absorption is lower, but scattering is higher. And because of that, because of this change in the absorption and scattering, you observe a change in the color. Okay, I hope you understand why the color is changing as we are changing the size of the metal nanoparticles. So smaller nanospheres primarily absorb light and have peaks near about 520 nanometer with narrow peak broadening. Okay, so let us see this figure A. Okay, so this is for gold nanoparticles having size in the range of 10 nanometer, 20 nanometer, 30 nanometer, and you can see the color from 10 to let us say 70. The lines are continuous. Okay, and after 80, 90, and 100, the lines are represented with dotted. The spectra is represented with dots. Okay, so if you carefully observe in this case, then you will realize that for 10, 20, 30, 40, okay, there is no much change. There is no much change in the optical density of gold nanoparticles. Okay, but as you are reaching to 50 and 60, okay, it is slightly changing. Okay, it is shifting towards the higher wavelength, And for in case of 80, 90 and 100 meter of volt nanoparticles, you can see that it's a absorption, plasmon resonance wavelength is also shifted. Okay, so these in a particular region like 10 to 50 nanometer, it is not that sensitive. Okay, it is changing, but it is not that sensitive. But if you go to 100 nanometer, then you can see that initially the spectra was narrow, but then it become broad. In case of 100 nanometer, the spectra slightly become broad and its intensity also goes down. So this is the how the light is interacting with different size of the metal nanoparticles. Now this is also very important graph as shown in B, where you can realize that on the y-axis is the scattering cross section and the x-axis is wavelength. So particularly if you see that if the size is 50 nanometer, then it's as I said, because the size is small, its scattering cross section is smaller. Okay, its scattering cross section is smaller, so it means its absorption will be higher. Okay, so you can see in case of 50, its absorption is higher. Okay, so if you go to 60, then scattering cross section is slightly increased, so absorption will be slightly decreased. Okay, so likewise you can see that as you are increasing the size of the metal nanoparticle, the scattering cross section is also increasing, and because the scattering cross section is increasing, its absorption is going down. Okay, so this is what is the this is the reason that the light is interacting differently for nanoparticles having different size. So larger sphere exhibit increased scattering and have peaks that broaden significantly and shifted toward longer wavelength, that is above 520 nanometer. That it is known as a redshifting. Okay, so that is shown in these two figures. Okay, so this is how you can realize that if the nanoparticles are very small, their absorption is higher and their scattering is lower. Okay, and if the nanoparticles are very big, then their absorption is lower and scattering is higher. And because of this change in the extinction coefficient, okay, you realize different types of color. Now let us try to understand what is the shape dependent SPR frequency, surface plasmon resonance frequency. Okay, so it is shape dependent. So if you change the shape of the nanoparticle, then the color of the nanoparticle or the extinction coefficient of the nanoparticle will get change. So that is we can try to understand with the help of figure A. Okay, so let us try to understand first figure A and then we will go to the text. So you can see that you all are familiar that when the size of the gold nanoparticle is smaller than wavelength of the electromagnetic radiation, then the whole electron cloud present in the gold nanoparticle started to oscillate, and there is a formation of surface plasma, localized surface plasmon resonance. Okay, so because the size is spherical in shape, okay, you all can realize that if the light is incident in any direction, okay, because the spherical size is symmetric in nature, their electron cloud can oscillate in that certain direction. Okay, so basically in case of a spherical nanoparticle, the light you incident in any direction, okay, the polarization is going to take place in only one direction. Okay, so you can see if the suppose the light is incident in this direction from left to right of the screen, then you can see that the polarization is take place in upward and downward direction. Okay, so this is how localized surface plasmons are generated in case of spherical nanoparticle. But now imagine a simple case where our gold nanoparticles are not in spherical shape. Suppose they are in nano rod kind of shapes. If you imagine the gold nanoparticles nano rods, okay, so if you imagine the gold nano rods, then what you can also imagine that the light can interact in this way, where the gold nano rods are horizontal in. So you can see that these gold nanoparticles are placed in horizontal direction, and these gold nanoparticles are placed in a vertical direction. So if the light is coming in this direction, okay, so this is in our electromagnetic wave, okay, that is the light. If light is coming in this direction, then this light is interacting with gold nanoparticles which are horizontally placed. So the light is interacting in a longitudinal direction, okay. So in this case, the polarization is take place in longitudinal direction. So here is your negative, here is positive for this amplitude, and for this amplitude here it is negative positive, and here it is negative, okay. So you can understand this. Suppose the gold nanorods are vertical in direction, but our light is get incident in the same direction, right? So in that case, what happens for this amplitude? Now we have positive negative head and positive tail of this nanorod, right? Similarly for this amplitude, okay, where the charges get opposed, okay, so positive in the upward direction, negative in the downward direction. It means the light is interacting with gold nanorods in different ways in different directions, okay. So one direction is called as longitudinal direction, and second direction is called as a transfer direction. So it is possible that there are two types of surface, localized surface plasmon resonance. So resonance can take place in this direction also, because here the plasmons are oscillating with certain frequency. So there is a one resonance frequency which is associated with the longitudinal direction, and second, there will be another plasmon resonance frequency which is associated with the transverse direction. So as you can observe, in case of spherical nanoparticles, you are observing a single type of spectra, okay. So there is a one peak in the spectra, there is a single peak which is associated in the spectra, because the size is spherical in shape, so it is symmetric in nature. But here you can see that because we are taking the non-spherical nanoparticles, okay, so this is a typical extinction spectra of non-spherical nanoparticles, okay, showing the bands assigned to the transverse and longitudinal plasmon resonance mode. So corresponding to transverse mode, you get a resonance. Okay. So here there is absorption is higher because there is a resonance in transverse mode, and the second longitudinal resonance will take place at different wavelength. Okay, because their thickness in this direction of nanorod is different, so you are getting two different peaks in the absorption of these gold nanorods. Okay, so instead of one peak, you are observing two different peaks. One belongs to transverse mode, and another belongs to longitudinal mode of in case of gold nanorods. Okay, now let us try to understand the text. So the shape of metallic nanoparticles contribute to spectral properties, okay, due to changes in the surface polarization. So there is a change in the surface polarization in this case, and there is change in the surface polarization in another case, and because of that this change, the spectral properties are going to change. The number of resonance absorption peak is determined by the number of modes in which a given nanoparticle can be polarized. Now this nanoparticle can polarize in two directions, therefore there are two modes, okay. So suppose if you take a complex geometry where there will be three different directions, in three different directions you can observe the plasmon peaks, then you may observe the three modes in case of the absorption spectra, okay. So depending upon that, depending upon the shape, you may have different modes of the localized surface plasmons. Okay. For example, the nanorods that can be polarized along two axes, that is transverse and longitudinal, exhibit two NSPR peaks. An increase in edges or sharpness of nanoparticle result in red shift of extinction spectra due to an increase in the charge separation. So basically, if the edges are very sharp, okay, so if you increase the number of edges or if you increase the sharpness of the nanoparticles, okay, or nanomaterials, I can say nanomaterials, then they result in the redshift of the extinction spectra. So here you can see some more examples of how shape varies with SPR frequency. Okay, so here in this case you can see I have compared the spherical, okay, with the nano rods. So when the metal nanoparticles are enlarged, so we have already seen in this case, their optical properties change only slightly as observed for the different samples of gold nanoparticles shown in figure A. Okay, so the peak remains same. Okay, the number of peak remains same, but they slightly get changed. But when an anisotropy is added, so this is not an isotropic. Spherical is an isotropic, but this is an anisotropic. Okay, so when this is added to the nanoparticles, such as growth of nanorods, the optical properties of the nanoparticle change dramatically. So you can see, if I change the length of the rod, okay, suppose the diameter of the rod remains fixed, because the diameter of the nano rods is fixed, you correspond to that, you are getting first peak at the that is the which case it is transverse mode. So the transverse mode for these gold nano rods remains same, okay, but their longitudinal mode is changing, because now you are changing the length of the nano rods. So as you are increasing the length of the nanorods, it is a longitudinal mode, okay, frequency, resonance frequency is shifting towards red. Okay, similarly you can see that suppose you have this kind of square, okay, instead of spherical in diameter, suppose these nanorods have a square kind of cross section, then you can see in all these cases, the cross section is same. Okay, let us say 50 nanometer. Okay, 50 nanometer by 50 nanometer. So if the cross section remains same, its transverse mode remains fixed. Okay, transverse mode remains fixed. So in here, this peak for all the absorption spectra remains same. Okay, but you can see that as you are increasing the length of these nano rods, square nano rods, then you can see that the second peak is going to change. That is, the longitudinal mode is going to change. Okay, also you can observe that compared to the gold nano rods, these are the gold squares, nano squares. Okay, so here, because there are edges are more, you can see, and there is an additional mode is observed. Okay, so one more peak is observed here. So basically, you are looking three peaks. Okay, one which is in this here, second is here, and third is here or here. Okay, so as I said, if you increase the number of edges, okay, or sharpness, then there is a more number of modes can be observed. Okay, so there are some complications, complicated shapes are also available. Okay, so this is like a nano rod kind of thing. Okay, but here you can see this is a star kind of shape is there, because it is a star kind of nano star in shape. So you can see it's a spectra is different. Okay, so this is how the shape is going to contribute, is going to affect on the optical properties of these metal nanomaterials. Okay, so let us see what is a compositional dependent SPR absorption. Okay, so as I said, up to now we are looking at only one type of metal, either it will be gold or it will be silver. But suppose if you are making an alloy of gold and silver, then what will happen? Okay, then what will happen? So for example, suppose in case of this material, where it is a pure gold. Okay? So when it is pure gold, you all are familiar that it has an absorption spectra maxima at the range of 525. So this spectra is belong to pure gold. But as you are adding silver in case of gold, so here XAU is equal to 0.8, means 0.2 is silver, 0.8 is gold and 0.2 is silver. Just by adding 0.2% of silver in the gold, you can see that it's a lambda max has got changed. Okay, then 0.54, so they are like 50-50 of it, and then gold is 0.27, so around 73% of this silver is here. So you can see this peak, and if you take pure silver, then it comes here. Okay. So there is a linear relationship between this percent of gold with the lambda max. So lambda max means what? The wavelength maximum, the wavelength where you observe the maximum absorption. Okay. So the wavelength which you observe. So for example, when x is equal to XAU is 1, then you can see it is up to 525. Okay. So it is at 525. Okay. So as you are reducing the gold and increasing the silver, then because the silver, the pure silver, okay, lambda max lies at 380. As I said, okay, so it is around 380. It is near to here. Okay, it is around 380. So here you can see that, okay, because silver is here, pure silver, and gold, pure gold is here. So if you start to add one element in another, then you have a linear relationship in the lambda max. Okay, so UV visible absorption spectra of gold and silver aligned nanoparticles as a function of gold mole fraction. So LSPR position as a function of gold mole fraction, illustrating the linear relationship between the position and composition in the gold and silver alloy system. Okay. So for more details, you can visit this paper where you may get more details about this composition dependent SPR absorption. Now the next thing is surrounding refractive index of surrounding material. So surroundings refractive index dependent SPR behavior, okay, SPR absorption. So let us start with this graph, easy to understand. The x-axis is wavelength, y-axis is extinction cross section, okay, and as you can see that this is the case for gold nanoparticles. Okay, this is the source from where I got this image. So these are the gold nanoparticles, okay, but when the gold nanoparticles are in air, then you can see that it's a extinction cross section is very small, okay, and when the gold nanoparticles are present in water, then its extinction coefficient has been increases. It means its absorption is increases, scattering becomes low. Okay, in case of air, the scattering is higher, absorption is lower, and in case of silica, so silica is a SiO2. Okay, so suppose your gold nanoparticles are coated with silica, then in that case the extinction cross section is very high. So its absorption is dominated here, okay, and the scattering goes down in case of silica. Okay, so this is how you can understand. Okay, whenever you look at these kind of graphs, now you have to immediately realize that there is a, how is the contribution of absorption and how is the contribution of scattering. So the optical properties of gold nanoparticles also depend on the refractive index near the nanoparticle surface. So you can also, if you remember, we have taken this one of the condition in the Mia theory. Okay, so we take two conditions there. One is basically belong to the size. Shape. So shape should be spherical in shape, and another we have taken care of the refractive index of the surrounding media. Okay, so we in that formula we have used the dielectric constants of the media. So this means the optical properties of gold nanoparticles also depend on the refractive index near the nanoparticle surface, and you can observe it as shown in the figure. The figure displays the calculated extinction spectra of 50 nanometer gold nanosphere. So you can see the size is constant, that is 50 nanometer.